We really needed a different way to cut trees. You start the assist machine, you turn on the main computer, and it's right in the cab of the assist machine. You adjust the throttle, and then you get out of that machine. You go over to the buncher, and then there's 1 through 8, and 1 does nothing, and 8 pulls really hard. We were introduced to the owner of Falcon, the assist machine. Rainier was very interested in this, as was I, because of getting people off the ground. That's the big reason we got into this type of logging. It's just a line that is on the end of the buncher and remote controlled. You go down the hill. When you want to come back up, you push numbers and it will assist you up the hill. I think it's turning out well. So that's, yeah, we're going to continue doing it.
So the DNR requires us anything over 30% slopes is what it is, not degrees, percent slopes. And so anything above that, we have to put something on that hillside that will help with the traction. They don't want us putting big ruts up and down the hillside, because when the rains come later, all that water runs down those gullies and it delivers sediment to the streams. And so it's just something we work hard at avoiding. Dave runs a feller buncher that's single drum winch. It's called a Falcon. And we've been using it about 4 years. It's just basically assisting that tractor to go up and down the hill and just assist, not hold it on the hillside, but just to help it go up and down the hill.
The most important thing concerning with this procedure is safety that we touched on. It's always our first concern. It gets people off the ground and it works really well. It's easy on the ground. It allows for good production when we log. We get a lot less breakage. It's very organized. From a distance from the drone, you look down on it, it should look like combed hair. And it does. It's easier on the rig and crew to get turns. The production goes way up. It just has a lot of positives.
We're trying to emphasize a culture of safety. It goes a long way, and we've been pushing that harder and harder almost every year. And I mean, realistically, from the standpoint of a manager, I don't see there's any greater job than I can do than to continue to push technology and get guys off the ground and out of the woods and into cabs.